We're going to ask you now to, we're going to do our opening song. We're all going to have to join together, make a joyful noise unto the Lord. And we're going to do praise him. And I know you've heard it. And we're going to take our time deliberately and individually praise him. It goes, praise him, praise him, praise him, praise him, Jesus, our blessed Savior. You've heard it before, and we're all going to sing it together. We're not worried about the sopranos, the altos. We just want to make a joyful noise. Glory unto our God and unto our Lord. Let's go now. Let's go. All right? Praise him. Praise him. Not too fast. Praise him. Praise him. Jesus, blessed Savior. He's worthy to be praised. Let's do that again. Praise him. Yes. Praise him. Praise him. Praise him. Jesus, blessed Savior, he's worthy to be praised. From the rising of the sun until the going down of the same, he is worthy. Jesus is worthy. He's worthy to be praised. Glory, glory, glory. Glory, glory, from Jesus, blessed Savior, he's worthy to be praised. Amen. And praise God for Jesus. And praise God for his word. I thank God. You know, we ought to always be prepared for him. Glory. There's some more words to that song, but we know the praise in our hearts. Yeah. And I was thinking on the way here, I'm saying, you know, I'm going to count on the screen. But listen, nobody has to put up a screen for me to praise our God. Right. We praise God. So we come in with praise on our hearts, yeah, and on our lips. And so we're going to give God the praise. Right now, we're going to do our scripture, which is taken from, which is Psalm 121. Amen. Psalm 121, the psalmist says, I will lift up mine eyes to the hills, from whence cometh my help. My help comes from the Lord, who made heaven and earth. He will not allow your foot to be moved. He who keeps you will not slumber. Behold, he who keeps Israel shall neither slumber nor sleep. The Lord is your keeper. The Lord is your shade upon your right hand. The sun shall not smite thee by day. No, the sun shall not strike you day by day. Let's see. I'm sorry. I have it right here. It's a New King James Version. Continue, Will.
The Lord shall preserve thee from all evil. He shall preserve thy soul. The Lord shall preserve thy going out and thy coming in from this time forth. And even
okay. Amen. Thank you. You may be seated. Our Father and our God, we thank you for blessing us to come together again. God, we thank you, and we are counting and depending on you. We came to worship you in spirit and in truth. And no matter how feeble it may seem, God, it is from the heart. And we know you know this. And God, we just enter into your gates happily. There are so many that couldn't get up this morning. But you blessed us and spared us to come with being aware of ourselves that we need to praise you. And God, we pray that our coming not be in vain. We know you have prepared the table for us through your anointed servant. God, we pray you will anoint him the more to give us your word in the spirit and in truth. And God, we lift you up in Jesus' name. Amen. We're going to sing a congregational hymn now that you all know, Trust and Obey. Okay? When we walk with the Lord in the light of His Word, what a glory He sheds on our way. What He says He will, we do. Where He leads, we will go. Never fear, only trust and obey. Everybody with the chorus. Trust and obey, for there's no other way to be happy in Jesus but to trust and obey. Amen. 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 We will now have our offering. The Lord loveth this cheerful giver. We are thankful for those who have the mind to give. God counts that also. Amen. And those who have been obedient to His word to bring forth the offering and tithes into His house. We pray now that God will bless you too. You can make. Certainly thank God for that. We thank God for the ushers. We thank God for each of you braving the weather today to come out. Yes. But our purpose is to come and praise and lift Him up and hear from heaven.
All right. Amen.
And as He has so designed and prepared His manservant, a pastor, to deliver and bring to us the word today, we're going to pray as he preaches. And then we'll pray that we will take this word in and use it to God's glory. We thank God for the opportunity and pastor here. You all may not know it, but that's my timer. He packed his foot, and that helps me keep time. We thank God. And Pastor, as you preach the word, you help us to stay in step in tune with God. We thank you, Pastor. So he serves in a whole lot of capacities. But I wanted to acknowledge that one that you might not know about. We praise God for that. And so the next voice you're going to hear after the song that they have prepared, it will be that of our pastor. We pray that you'd pray for him and prepare your hearts to receive what it is the Lord is saying to us today. We thank God for him.
Find favor in your sight, Lord, please hear my heart's cry. I'm desperately waiting to be where you are. Across the hottest desert, I'll travel.
Favor in your sight.
Lord, please, Lord, please.
gotta be where you are. I wanna be where you are. Gotta be where you are. Come on, raise it before him, say, wanna be where you are. Gotta be.
Gotta be where you are.
I wanna be where.
Wanna be where.
Wanna be where,
wanna be you, where are. You are.
Oh, I gotta be there.
Gotta be where you are.
Come on, worshiper, tell him I wanna be where you are.
Wanna be where you are.
Gotta be where.
Come on, lift your hands in this place. Tell the Lord I want to be where you are. Amen.
Amen.
Come on, tell the Lord I want to be where you are. Amen. Father, we are grateful this morning for another opportunity, God, to come into your presence, because your word says in your presence there is a fullness of joy.
Yeah.
And at your right hand there is pleasure forevermore.
Amen. Amen.
So, Father God, as we come today, Lord God, we thank you that your word says that, Lord God, that greater is he that's in us than he that's in the world. Lord God, we come this morning to say thank you for another worship experience. Lord God, we come into this place, Lord God, not for religious routine, Lord God, not for ritual reasons, but God, we come in here to worship and praise your name. You said in your word, if you would be lifted up, God, you would do the drawing. And so, Lord God, we need to be drawn closer to you. So, God, we lift you up with our mind, and we lift you up with our mouth, Lord God. We lift you up, God, with every motive, Lord God, that's on the inside of us, in the name of Jesus. And, God, I thank you for it right now. Now, Lord, thank you for the Holy Spirit, who is our comforter, who is our guide, who is our paraclete, the one who comes alongside of us. Father, we pray in the name of Jesus as we go in to your word, God, allow your Holy Spirit to, Lord God, illuminate your word this morning, that your word would be a lamp to our feet, that it would be a light unto our pathway. We pray today, Lord God, that the word will fall on good ground. We pray for the spirit of comprehension today, Lord God, that your people would know without a shadow of a doubt that you are God who knows all and see all and have all power in your hand. We give your name the glory, the honor, the praises, and we thank you for it. In Jesus' name, amen. Come on, I'm going to need you to participate this morning. Come on, clap your hands this morning. Amen. I know it's daylight saving time and we lost hours of sleep, but amen, we come in this place to worship and praise God. Amen. Come on, clap your hands this morning. Amen. Amen. First of all, we give God the honor. We give God the glory. We give God the praises. We magnify his name. For there is no other name upon earth that man can be saved by. We praise him that he has allowed us another opportunity to come into this place, a place where we come to worship God. Amen. This is not a religious experience that we come into this place, but when we come in this place, we come as vessels, amen, fit for the master's use to give back to him what he has given to us, saints of God. And so we praise him for that this morning. We thank God for our wife, amen. Thank you, First Lady, one of the smartest women I know, amen. And we praise God for her, amen. She's a smart woman, I'm telling y'all, saints, amen. For you that don't know her, you need to get to know her. She's a smart woman, amen. And so we praise God for this morning, amen. She got to be smart if she married to me, amen. Praise his holy name. Amen, amen, amen. Thank you this morning, amen, Reverend Staten, amen, for your service, amen, and your participation. Most of all, Reverend Staten, thank you so much for your diligence, amen, and what you do, amen. Thank God for our deacons this morning, amen, for Brother Michael, who's here, Reverend Brother DeBrow, amen, Brother DeBrow, Brother Banks, amen, and Brother Thomas, amen, who's not in our midst this morning. Thank God for our trustees. We praise God for you this morning. Thank God for, amen, our ushers. Thank God for the media ministry, amen, and thank God most of all for you, saints of God. We are grateful to God this morning that you would make your way out to the house of the faith. We know that we have other, amen, screams, amen, of, amen, communication that you can hear the service. But we praise God, amen, for your participation of coming. And I believe if you're going to come, amen, you ought to participate while you're here, amen. Every now and then you ought to clap your hands. You ought to say amen up under the mask, amen. You can say amen, amen, and God will be glorified in our lives, amen. This morning, amen, I want you to turn with me over to the book of Mark. Mark the 8th chapter. Mark the 8th chapter. Amen. Thank God for all of you this morning. We're in prayer with Brother Eddie. Brother Eddie lost, amen, a loved one on last evening. So we're in prayer for him, he and his family, and everyone else who may be faced, amen, with a moment of bereavement. Amen. We're praying by faith that God will comfort, amen, your heart, Brother Eddie. Amen. You and your family, amen. I know you'll probably be traveling this week. Amen. But we're praying to God, amen, that God will comfort you, amen, during this time of separation. Mark the 8th chapter, starting at the 34th verse. Mark the 8th chapter, starting at the 34th verse. Amen. Amen. Mark the 8th chapter, starting at the 34th verse. Also, we're praying for, amen, continue on believing God for, amen, Brother Reverend Brown's healing. Amen. We know by faith that he's already healed. Amen. And as he's in his recovery stage, we are praying by faith, amen, that God would give him a speedy recovery. Amen. So, saints of God, we all need prayer. Amen. There is something going on in all of our lives, whether it's spoken or unspoken. All of us need prayer this morning. And so we praise God for that. We're going to talk about this morning. It costs to be involved. It costs to be involved. Amen. Thank you, Sister Heather. It costs to be involved. Amen. Amen. One of the many realities of living as an adult, as an adult life, is that everything you do comes with a cost. Amen. I know you know that this morning. It makes no difference if you are 18 or you're 98. They will have to pay something to live in the world in which we live in. One of the things I've learned, amen, that when I communicate with young adults, one of their biggest fears that they face is paying bills and having enough money to live comfortable on, amen, as they live independently from their parents. However, one of the realities of living as an adult is that it comes with a price tag. I want y'all to hear me this morning. I can recall growing up, amen, and witnessing my mother, witnessing my parents. I can recall them, my mother, on many, many occasions, always paying her bills. And even to the point, she would invite Lane and I into the conversation, allow us to write the check sometimes to pay the bill. And I can recall, I can remember, Mrs. McIntosh, I can remember so vividly that my mother would always tell us, as growing up as young kids, amen, if you pay your bills on time, you will have good credit. And if you have good credit, you can buy whatever you desire because everything will come with the cost. I can remember those conversations. And I don't know what your personal struggle may be. I don't know what your personal, amen, your personal struggle, your personal story is this morning when it comes to calls. But the one thing I want to let all of us understand that's upon the sound of my voice, that everything that you and I will ever do in this world in which we live in will come with a price tag. Amen. It's going to come with a price tag. And I've come to realize is that because Jesus died on the cross 2,000 years ago, he has given all of us good credit that whatever we need is already paid for. Do you believe that this morning? Jesus has already done it. Whatever I need, amen. Whatever I need, Brother McIntosh, whatever I need, Brother JJ, it's already done. If we could ever come to that conclusion that I don't have to beg for nothing, I don't have to bargain for nothing, amen. I don't have to barter for nothing because everything I need in life is already paid for. As a matter of fact, I can recall when Merle and I first got married, we was young lads in love with each other. Didn't have a whole lot, amen, but we had each other and we had God. And I know Merlin can remember the story. Merlin wanted this Broad Hill bedroom suit, amen. Cost a lot of money at that time. And I didn't know how in the world I was going to be able to pay for that Broad Hill bedroom suit, Brother Willie J, amen. Because sometimes when the wife asks for things, we as men, it's our responsibility to make sure that we can be that underprovider from God to provide for them. And as I went down to that store, I can recall vividly, me and that man began to start talking, and he began to give me the price tag of that bedroom suit and that mattress, amen, and that, amen, that computer cabinet. He gave me that figure, and I said, Lord, how in the world I'm going to pay that? But he said, Mrs. Choice, I have something for you. That if you got good credit, come on, saints, we will give you tax-free, amen, we will give you interest-free for 18 months, and you want to pay, amen, any more above that. And what that taught to me in my mind, the same way Jesus' name is so good to us, that whatever comes in our way, God has already allowed the cost to be paid because we have a name that's above all names. Pastor, what are you saying? Trying to say this morning? What I'm trying to say this morning, that Jesus' name is so great in our lives that when the price comes, the price has already been paid. And maybe that's why Solomon said in the book of Proverbs, the 22nd chapter, the first verse, he says, a good name is rather to be chosen than great riches, and loving favor rather than silver and gold. And what Solomon was implying to all of us this morning, that when we have a good name, our name represents our character. Are y'all with me? That's why Jesus asked his disciples, who do men say that I am? Some says you're Elijah. Some says you're a prophet. Amen. Some say you're John the Baptist. But then he turns around and changed the trajectory to his disciples, and he said, now, who do you say that I am? And y'all know it was Peter, the one who's outspoken. It was Peter that spoke up and says, you are the Son of the living God, amen. And Jesus tells him, upon this rock I'm going to build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail. What he was trying to tell Peter, that when you go through life, everything you're going to experience is going to come with the cost. But he says, upon this rock I'm going to build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. And when I think about a good name, it speaks, as I stated, it speaks of someone's reputation, or it gives valuable, it's a valuable to who they are as a child of God. And as a born-again believer, Jesus' name is a good name. And he's promised, according to the word in the book of Philippians, that at the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow, of those in heaven and those on earth and those upon the earth, and of every tongue shall confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of the Father. And Jesus gives us a name that makes us have good credit on earth. He paid the price 2,000 years ago, and as I stated before, whatever we need, saints of God, it's all in the name of Jesus. So you don't have to fret or worry this morning, because the price tag is going up. Because if you stand in the name of Jesus, it's already been paid. Come on, clap your hands this morning if you believe that. When we take a look this morning at our text, Jesus is teaching his disciples that if they are going to be involved with him, it's going to come with a cost. Let us take a close look at this text, and there are many different illustrations where Jesus shows his disciples that there is a cost to be involved. Yes, saints of God, it costs to be involved. I don't know if you know that this morning. If we take a look at Mark, the 8th chapter, the 1st through the 10th verse, the cost to feed the hungry is to have a heart of compassion. The multitude had nothing to eat, and Jesus has compassion on the multitude by taking 7 loaves and 2 fish and feeding 5,000. Jesus shows us in the scripture, if you're going to be a person that's going to feed the hungry, it's going to cost you compassion. Also, he shows us in the same text, amen, in Mark the 8th chapter, 22nd through the 26th verse, the cost for the blind man to see was to believe in the miracle of humility. Are y'all with me this morning? Jesus spits on the man's eyes and places his hands upon him. And he was able to see. The miracle of humility is humbling oneself under the mighty hand of God that he may exalt you in this season. But as Jesus, we look this morning, we're going to find that Jesus is going to summon his disciples and followers to him, because he's trying to give them a practical lesson about what it takes to be involved in the kingdom of God. And I don't know if you know about this, saints of God. Amen. As a child of God, when you accept Jesus as your Lord and your Savior, God is looking to see if we are willing to, amen, to pay the cost to be involved. I know that some of us, amen, we believe that we can just do it our way. Are y'all with me this morning? But if you're going to be a follower of Jesus, it's going to take that you will be a person that would do it his way. So the first point as we take a look, amen, in verse 34, amen, when we look at, amen, what it costs to be involved, whosoever desires to be involved, the first condition is to be willing, i.e., ready or prepared to do something. Can I say that one more time, saints of God? If you and I are going to be people that's going to be involved with God, the first condition is you and I must be willing. Let me say that one more time so that may go over somebody's head. Many, many times people of God say they want to do things in God, but when the opportunity is presented to them, they are not willing to walk by faith that God would do great things in their lives. Look what he says in that verse. He says in verse 34, and when he had called the people unto him with his disciples also, he said unto them, whosoever will come after me, let him first deny himself, take up his cross, and follow him. As you can see this morning, that Jesus, he speaks in relationship terms to his disciples, because he says, if you come after me and want to be my disciple, the first thing you must do is that let him deny, meaning that you as a person has to be willing to do what God has called you to do. Maybe some of you haven't called it yet this morning. What I'm saying this morning, amen, if you and I are going to be people that God's going to use, amen, when the opportunity comes and he presents it to us, we have to be willing to do what he asks us to do. Maybe some of you still didn't catch it, amen. Let me still knock down the wall, amen. If you're going to follow Jesus, if you're going to get all that God has rewarded for you, amen, when he presents the door open to you, if you're not willing to walk in the door, maybe that makes more sense. Amen. Something you will not receive all that God has for you. Amen. Well, let me still see if I can knock that down a little bit more. Amen. If we're going to be people that's going to receive the promises that God has for us, amen, when he, amen, brings people in our lives, and those people, amen, cause us to do it a different way and move from that comfortable place we're in, and we're not willing to receive those people, amen, we're not going to receive the reward of God. I don't believe I can explain it no more, amen, saints of God. So what God is trying to show us this morning, when it comes to being involved with God, the first thing we have to do is be willing. Come on, touch yourself this morning and say, God, I'm willing. God, I'm willing. Amen. So how do you know you're willing? Amen. Because the Bible tells us this way. He says, you got to be first willing to deny yourself. Well, Pastor, what is denial? Denial means not to walk in the flesh. Are y'all with me this morning? So when Jesus says, if you're going to be involved with me, you cannot walk in your flesh, meaning do it your way like you want to do it. How do you know that? Because the Bible said it this way in the book of Romans, the 8th chapter, the 8th verse. It says, those who walk in the flesh cannot please God. That's Bible, saints. So Jesus helps us understand this morning, if we're going to be involved with him, it takes for us to deny ourselves, meaning that we cannot walk in the flesh and do it our way. And I know that's hard for some of us to believe. But if you're going to do it God's way, and you're going to keep hearing me say this over and over, if you're going to do it God's way, you've got to do it, amen. If you're going to receive God's reward, you've got to do it God's way. Second point he said in the scripture, not only do you deny yourself, but you got to take up your cross. Everybody in the room this morning, you have a cross this morning. And the cross represents a place where you walk in total humility to God. Yeah. It means you don't walk in pride. That means you don't, it ain't your way. That means, amen, you do it God's way. Are y'all with me this morning? So he says the second thing, if you're going to be involved with me, the condition is you got to be willing, amen, but most of all, you got to deny yourself and you got to take up your cross. Well, the Bible said this way in the book of 1 Corinthians, amen, the first chapter, the 18th verse, for the word of the cross is foolishness. Y'all got to hear this morning. To those who are perishing. But to us who are being saved, it is the power of God. Can I read that one more time? The Bible says, for the word of God, for the word of the cross is foolishness to those who are perishing. Who are the ones who's perishing? Those who are not saved. But he says to us, but to us who are being saved, it is the power of God. So when Jesus says, pick up your cross and follow me, those that are not saved are not going to pick up their cross and follow Jesus because they don't want to be involved with him. Are y'all with me? And can I say something this morning, saints of God? You need to hear me when I share with you. Amen. Just because you're on the church roll, just because you've been taking a pew, amen, that does not mean that you're a follower of Christ Jesus. So he says, amen, if you're gonna be involved with me, you got to deny yourself. That means don't walk in your flesh. You got to also not deny yourself, but you got to have a mindset of humility. And third thing he says, if you're going to follow me, amen, he says, after you take up your cross, then you can follow me. That means what he's saying is that every footstep that you make is going to be ordered by God. How do you know that, Pastor? Because the Bible says in the book of Proverbs, he says in 3:5-7, he says, trust in the Lord with all thy heart and lean not to thy own understanding. In all thy ways acknowledge him, and he shall direct your path. He says, do not be wise, come on, saints, in your own eyes. Fear the Lord and depart from evil. The scripture says, amen, following Jesus, you cannot be wise in your own eyes. And Pastor, why do you keep saying this to us over and over every week? Because God has downloaded to me every week, amen, that we as a body of Christ, amen, some of us has got so comfortable to believe, amen, that the way we do it is the right way, amen, and it's really the wrong way that God has called us out to do it. Are y'all with me this morning? And so, if you're going to be involved, three things. You got to deny. You got to take up your cross, and then you can follow. Second point that, amen, the scripture said, tells us, he says, if you're going to be involved, whosoever desire to be involved, the second condition is that you got to understand wealth. Watch what I show you. I'm going to show you wealth, saints of God. You got to understand wealth. Because many times we think wealth is based upon what we have on earth. Are y'all with me? I don't care how many CDs I have. I don't care how many thrift saving plans I have. I don't care how much money I have in the bank. If I leave here tomorrow, it's going to stay right here, saints. So we sometimes, amen, think wealth is based upon what we have required or what we acquired in life. Please don't misunderstand me. We should be all people that have goals, amen, when it comes to our finances. But please don't misunderstand me. Your finances will not get you into the place where God would have you to be at. If you're going to be involved with God, you got to really understand what true wealth means in God. Look what the Bible says, 35, 36, and 37. Can I teach in this house? Amen. The Bible says, for whosoever will save his life shall lose it. But whosoever shall lose his life for the sake of the gospel, the same shall save it. Look what he says. He says, for what shall it profit a man that if he shall gain the whole world and lose his soul? Or what shall it, will a man, excuse me, and what shall a man give in exchange for his own soul? What Jesus is trying to help his disciples, like he's trying to help us, amen, we got to understand that involvement, you got to understand what true wealth is. True wealth is that you lose your soul, amen, for the things of God. You don't lose your soul for the world, saints, amen. And yes, there are so many people, amen, that call themselves born again believers. And they're so, amen, entitled and holding on, amen, to the things that God has given them. Can I suggest something to you this morning, saints of God, again, that if you and I leave off the planet on tomorrow, I promise you everything that we have stored up, somebody's going to use it, amen, because, amen. Amen. We sometimes think that wealth is based upon houses and lands and CDs, amen, amen, and buildings. But wealth is placed upon you having a heart that hungers and thirsts after God. And when you hunger and thirst after God, he will fill you. Are y'all with me this morning? So he says in the scripture, whosoever shall be involved with me, you got to understand what true wealth is. I've learned, saints of God, I don't worry about finances. Can I say that one more time? I don't worry about money. Why? Because the Bible teaches me that he is my supplier. If he's my supplier, everything we have need of is already done. Are y'all with me this morning? It may not be in the bank right now. Amen. It may not be, amen, on the record right now, but everything we have need of is supplied. Why? Because when I need it, that's when God supplies it. Amen. If I don't need it, he don't supply it. Are y'all with me this morning? So if you're not getting things in your life, come on, saints, amen, it's because you don't need it right now. But whenever you need it, God is going to supply it. So if we want to be involved as a child of God, you got to really understand what wealth really is. Wealth is not money. Wealth is not power. Wealth is that your soul is connected to Jesus. Are y'all with me this morning? And I praise God this morning that I can stand and decree and declare, amen, that God have said, amen, all your needs will be met according to my riches and glory. Whatever you need, God has already paid the price that you shall have it, amen, and you will, amen, rejoice in it. Are y'all with me this morning? Come on, clap your hands this morning if you believe that. Third point this morning about involvement. I see that I understand wealth, Pastor. I understand, amen, if I'm going to be involved with God, I got to be willing. I want that to fall on some good ground this morning. Because some of us, amen, have made up in our mind that we can't do certain things. Are y'all with me this morning? But can I tell you something this morning, saints of God? If God be for you, who can be against you? If God said you can do it, guess what? You can do it. If God say you can have it, guess what? You can have it. If God says it's possible, believe it this morning because it's possible. Third point and final point. If I'm going to be involved with God, whatsoever I desire, amen. Amen. Whosoever desire to be involved, the final condition is to not be ashamed of his word. Yeah, saints. You can't be ashamed of his word. Amen. Because as you're a child of God, you got to stand on what God's word says. Not stand on, amen, what grandma said and what granddaddy said. Not stand on what the world is saying. Stand on what the word of God says. If you read the word, everything that we're faced with in the world we live in is all in the word. And that's why there's no reason to be fretting and getting scared because of what's going over in Russia, because it's right there in the word. Are y'all with me? Bible says in the 38th verse, final verse, it says, and whosoever therefore shall be ashamed of me and my words, plural. He says, in this adulteress, now this is the thing that bothered me right here, Reverend State, in this adulteress and sinful generation, of him also shall the Son of Man be ashamed when he cometh in the glory of his Father with the holy angels. The word of shame, amen, it implies to be embarrassed. Are y'all with me this morning? And sometimes as a child of God, when you're around unsaved people try to make you feel bad about being saved. But I don't have no problem with unsaved people. My problem lies when you say you're a child of God. And you say, amen, you're born again. And every time I bring a scripture to you, you knock that scripture down based upon what you've been taught. That's where my problem lies at. Are y'all with me this morning? So Jesus says, amen, it costs to be involved. And the cost, amen, is that you would never be embarrassed of his word. I can remember growing up, amen, when I first got saved. When I first accepted Christ as my personal savior. And when people begin to start mocking the church, y'all know what I'm talking about. They make fun of the church. They make fun of people who go to church. And when I was a young child, amen, a young lad in the word of God, I had no comeback. But praise God for growth and experience. Because when I find somebody who now marks the church, I tell them, listen, the last person that's going to speak over your body will be a pastor. He will be a priest. He will be somebody, amen, who has authority over your life. And that's why you ought to not make fun of the church, because there's going to come a time in your life that you're going to need somebody in the church to help bring you through. Are y'all with me this morning? So Jesus says you can't be ashamed. Involvement means you can't be embarrassed to be a child of God. You can't be embarrassed of God's word. Amen. Why? Because if you're embarrassed of God's word, the word of God says the Son of Man shall be ashamed and embarrassed of you when he comes in the glory of his Father and his holy angels. And so, Pastor, what are you saying to us this morning? The world in which we're facing, what they're calling what we're going through, amen, inflation. Inflation happens when prices rise and the consumer has to pay more for goods and service. But may I suggest to you this Sunday morning, just like the price of gas has gone up and food has gone up, the price tag for salvation has not changed. Are y'all with me this morning? The song says, on a hill far away stood an old rugged cross. The emblem of suffering and shame. I love that old cross were the dearest and the best for the world lost sinners and for shame. And may I ask a question this morning here at CBC? Amen. Are you willing, amen, to pay the cost to be involved? Are you willing not to walk in the flesh? That's the question this morning. Are you willing, amen, to work, amen, one with another in unity? That's a question for us this morning. Are you willing, amen, to witness for Jesus at any cost? Are you willing to pay the cost when things don't go your way? Oh, my God. Are you willing to pay the cost when people embarrass you and call you everything but a child of God? Are you willing to walk, amen? Are you willing to work? Are you willing to trust the word of God, amen, when God is taking too long? And are you willing, amen, to do the things that God has ordained you to do? Saints of God, God is calling us this morning to let us understand, amen, if we're going to be involved, it's going to come with a cost, amen. But can I tell you my story? It was at the cross where I first saw the light. And all the burdens of my heart, they rolled away. It was there by faith I received my sight, and now I'm happy all the day. Pastor, why are you happy? Because the price tag has been paid, saints. Amen. And all that God has for me is for me. And praise God, no weapon, no demon in hell can, amen, take that away. I praise God this morning that I'm involved with him. Why? Because I'm willing to pay the cost, because I gave my life many years ago that he would live and live on the inside of me. And so God is telling us this morning, saints of God, it costs to be involved. Just like people pay dues to be in clubs, every due that you and I owe, it's already been paid. But now Jesus is saying, are you willing to accept the paycheck? Are you willing, amen, to deny yourself? Are you willing to pick up your cross? Are you willing to follow him? That's what he's asking us this morning. Everything we have need of has already been paid. But are we willing to do what God has ordained us to do? You know, when I think about this ministry And I think about, amen, this assignment I'm on. I don't believe that God called me here at Caris just to let the church be what it was when I got here. Are y'all with me this morning? I believe that God called me here to cause change in the place that we worship. And that's why I'm so aggressive when it comes to breaking down strongholds and breaking down fallow ground and breaking down how we used to do it. Because we live in a new time, saints. And if we're going to grab hold to the new revelation, we've got to do it differently. Are y'all ready with me this morning, saints? We got to do it differently. And that means according to God's word. That means according to God's word. And I know it's going to cost me something. I know people are going to talk about me. I know they're going to put rumors out on me. I know they're going to scandalize my name and my wife's name. But praise God, I'm willing to take the cost. Because the price tag has already been paid. And for me to stand and declare and decree that there is no weapon that's formed against me shall prosper. And every tongue that rise up against me, it will be devoured. Change got to take place, saints. We can't do it the way we've always done it. I know that's the most comfortable way, and that's what all of us know. But how many know that God is trying to take us into a new season? And every time I think about this ministry, I think about where we're at, but I think about where we can go. I think about where we can go. Why? Because the price tag has been paid. And all God is seeing now, are you willing to walk through the door? Just like those doors are wide open right there, are you willing to walk through the door, saints? Are you willing? Everything is changing the world we live in. For some reason, we as people that come to church don't believe that the church should change. We don't believe that God is evolving us. He really is. And we say we're people of faith. I'm talking to the congregation this morning. We say we're people of faith. Well, faith moves. Faith don't stand still. I look totally different at 55 than I did at 25. Because gravity is moving. And if I stay here for 15 years and we're still doing the same thing we were doing when I first got here, something's wrong with me as a pastor. And can I say this, saints? Something should be wrong with you as a people of God. If you don't require your leaders to take you to another level, something's wrong. You should put a demand on the anointing of God to take. Read the scripture. Every time that Jesus met somebody, would he not take them to another level? But religion has taught us, stay where you're at. No, don't do it that way. Hey, no, we can't pay for it. Listen, I don't care what the price tag says. Amen. God has already paid the price. All we got to do is walk out in it, especially there's a need. And I know some of you get, amen, uneasy when you talk about money. Amen. But I'm not a begging preacher. No, I'm not. Amen. But I'm a preacher who walks by faith and not by sight. And I know if we're going to be people, that, amen, that's going to give into the pot, amen, the pot ought to sometime provide something for the people. Y'all with me this morning? Come on, stand on your feet this morning. Stand on your feet this morning. I'm telling you, I've been talking to the Lord, and the Lord's been talking to me, and he's been talking to me about this ministry. And I refuse to sit back and see there needs to have change in the house and be afraid to invoke change. And I'm talking to this congregation. All of us go here, amen. I refuse. 3 years now, it's been 3 years I've been on the scene now, 3 years. 3 years, amen. Jesus got up out the grave on the third day, saints. Y'all better hear what I'm telling you. He got up out the grave on the third day. 3 years. Time for us to get on up. Come on, clap your hands this morning. Time for us to get on up. We've been sitting back for 3 years. Time to get on up and move forward. Do y'all believe that this morning? Do y'all believe, amen, that I'm credible enough, amen, that God has called me to help us get on up and start moving? 3 years. Well, Father, we thank you again this morning. Lord God, that you've shown in your word it costs to be involved. And I thank you, Lord God, that you're a personal God. That when you called the disciples and those followers to you, God, you was trying to see where their level of belief was at. You speak to them, Lord God, and tell them, whosoever shall be my disciple, first deny himself, pick up his cross and follow me. God, you teach them about, Lord God, willingness, and you teach them, Lord God, Father God, about wealth, but you teach them most of all about your word. And so, Father, I pray this morning in the name of Jesus here at Carey's Baptist Church, God, that we, your people, will get an understanding of who you really are and what you really require in our lives. God, so much potential is in you that, God, our mind, Lord God, cannot even conceive it. But, God, I praise you and I honor you, Lord God, right now that your word tells us that eyes have not seen, ears have not heard, nor have an into man's heart prepared for your people. But God is through the Spirit. And I pray this morning, God, that you would breathe a fresh anointing upon us, Lord God. That God, every barrier, Lord God, every bridge, Lord God, every, Lord God, border that we have to cross, that God, you give us the strength to do it in the name of Jesus. I pray for these people here, Lord God, that you have place me, Lord God, to be the overseer, God, and the under shepherd of you. I pray, God, that you would give them a fresh anointing and give them a fresh revelation. God, show them the vision, Lord God, that you've cast in this house is to develop disciples of all ages, teaching them to know that they are born of the Spirit of God and all of your promises, it belongs to them. God, I pray that we as a body of Christ would be on one accord for the vision. That God, that we will go out into the hedges and highways. We'll go out even to our own homes and bring those in that are not saved in the name of Jesus. I thank you and I praise you, God, for the authority that you have given us. You said it in your name, Lord God, that we have the authority, Lord God, to tread upon serpents. You said in your name, God, we have the authority to speak in unknown tongues. You said in your name, God, we have the authority to lay hands upon the sick, and they shall recover. So, God, we send in you the anointing of the authority of your name this morning, and we declare and decree that this house will be a house of worship. It will be a house, Lord God, that you will be pleased with in the name of Jesus. We honor you and we praise you and we thank you for it right now. God, we pray in the name of Jesus. There's anyone here this morning that do not know who you are. We pray, God, they will confess with their mouth and believe in their heart that you have, that Jesus was raised from the grave, God, and you said they will be saved. The price tag has already been paid. God, we give your name the glory, the honor, and the praises, and we count it done. In Jesus' name, amen. Come on, clap your hands. Zion is calling me to a higher place of praise, to stand upon the mountain and magnify your name. To tell all the people and all the nation that you reign. Zion is calling me to a higher place of praise. Come on, say it with me. Come on. Zion is calling me to a higher place a praise to stand upon the mountain and magnify your name, to tell all the people and all the nation that he reigns. Come on, Zion. Zion is calling me to a higher place of praise. Come on, one more time. Zion. Zion is calling you to a higher place of praise, to stand upon the mountain and magnify his name, to tell all the people and all the nation that he reigns. Zion is calling you to a higher place of praise. Come on, clap those hands this morning. Amen. Let us prepare our hearts, amen, to leave this place. Amen. Continue on keeping Brother Eddie and keeping Reverend Brown, amen, in your prayers, amen. If Reverend Brown's not here next Sunday, I'm going to get with the choir during the week, amen. We're going to have a musician come in and help us on next Sunday, so be prepared for that. But I'm believing God Reverend Brown will be here. But if he's not here, amen, choir, get ready, amen. We're going to get with you, amen, for you are singing. Bring a young man in that's going to help us, amen, with his music ministry. Praise his holy name. The work got to keep going, saints of God. And so we praise God for that this morning. Amen. Let's pray. Father, thank you again this morning for all that our ears have heard and all that our eyes have witnessed. Lord, as we leave this place, we never leave your presence. We pray the love of God. We pray the sweet communion of the Holy Spirit. Lord, let it rest, rule, and abide within our hearts. God, I pray you keep us, never to leave us, and we'll give your name the glory, the honor, and the praises. It is in Jesus' name we pray. Let the church say amen. God bless you, saints.